Trust me, guys, one thing I want to share when it comes to SQL, my interest in Oracle, it all started with SQL. The first time when I saw this command, select star from EMP, it's a very simple command, okay? Select star from EMP. I was like, come on, it's so simple. I mean, it's so easy to remember those kind of commands. Why would I want to write loops? Why would I want to write if conditions? Those simple English statements makes more sense to me rather than those complex loops or if and else conditions. And that was the, I think this one statement actually attracted me more than anything else. And then I, when I got into understanding the RDBMS concepts, it was so easy. I was able to understand almost every simple thing in the RDBMS. And then I went so deep that I had to choose Oracle as my technology. So today we'll be starting with very simple and basic terms. Let us get our foundation right. So most of you are freshers who don't even know anything about Oracle SQL. That's perfectly okay because we are starting right from scratch. Some of you who might already been already have an experience as an Oracle DBA, they are here to understand the high-end SQL queries and to clear the 10071 certification exam. Some of you might already know the concepts that I'm going to talk, but I'm going to start right from the scratch, ground zero, so that everyone understands everything. All right, so let us start with something called as data. Why do you think we need to store the data? I'll give you some examples. See, you have, you make so many calls, right? You have so many calls, you write so many messages. You need a way in order to track the history, right? That means if you want to track something, you need to store the events. A event can be described in simple English sentences, and you store those events for your future reference. So all the data in today's world, the data is being generated like hell, because you have messages, you have calls, you have WhatsApp, you have Messenger, you have Facebook, social media, emails. And in the last 4 or 5 years, you might have seen that the data has increased, right? What does that mean? Because a lot of people have started using the social media and everyone is generating more data. Can you guess how many videos are uploaded on YouTube per minute? A lot of videos, like thousands of videos uploaded every minute onto YouTube. Now that's a lot of data. But when these kind of activities happen, who uploaded the video, when the video was uploaded, what is the length of the video, what is the title of the video, what is the description of the video, what is the status of the video, whether it is private or public video, it's all data. It's all the different dimensions that you want to save about something. Data is nothing but you define a property about something. So like all your call logs are nothing but it's all properties about your calling history. All your messages, it's nothing but it's properties about your chats, right? So data is nothing but it's a collection of a particular event that happened at a particular time. But when it comes to an event, an event can have, again, further properties, right? For example, coming back to the same YouTube example, you uploaded the video, but you again want to know how many likes came, how many comments came, how many people shared the video, what is the watch time, how many people watched the video. Because I have a YouTube channel, so I know this. You can even look into exactly at what minute people are dropping off from your video. Even those kind of analytics is available. So when you have data, you also have some properties about the data, and you again have further properties that you want to store. Now the question is, there is so much data, where are you going to store this data?